Welcome to Between Heaven and Earth, an internet radio talk show where we help you connect spirit and divine guidance. Lisa Kay, your host, brings you shows that can enhance and transform your life with tips and new ideas for more happiness, abundance, and better relationships. Lisa is an expert on intuition and can show you how to strengthen your inner guidance to empower yourself. Each show is positive and uplifting to inspire your day. Her guest speakers are specialists on self-help, positive thinking, spirituality, and conscious living. Be the best that you can be with Between Heaven and Earth, conscious living for your soul.
Hey there, it's Lisa Kay, and we are back for another episode of Between Heaven and Earth Radio. And today, our show is called, Should You Act on Your Intuition? Now, I know we've all heard, oh, you should always respond to your intuition, or if you get that intuitive nudge, you have to act on it. But do you have to act on everything your intuition tells you? This is one of the most common concerns I get from people. My students often ask me this question. Sometimes I get information for other people. What should I do? And for example, someone would say to me, I was on the line at the store the other day, and suddenly my intuition told me some information about the person in front of me. I didn't know what to do. I felt like I had to tell them. What should I do? Or in my Trust Yourself course just recently, and which is running now, one of my students asked a similar question. This is a good question. Why do I get intuitive messages about other people that may not even be close to me? Why do I need to know this information? So first of all, let's talk about where we think the messages come from. Now, it can come from a lot of different places, and I believe it does. I believe it comes from what other people have said as well, is that it comes from our higher selves, or that it comes from angels, or our souls. Or it could be that it's coming from the rest of your brain, because the rest of your brain that's not your, say, thinking mind, that's the part of your brain that has clarity and wisdom. Or it could be the universe sending us information from our environment or other sources that your intuitive mind has picked up that you're not completely aware of. Now, these, I believe, if you're a good person and you have good intentions, is all good information. And any one of these sources support you. But regardless of where the information comes from, it doesn't necessarily mean that the intuition you received is something you have to share with people. Because the intuitive information you get, it's like the news. It's just information. So the question is, how do you know what to act on? If you get information that's intuitive about someone else, especially a stranger, you run the risk of them getting angry with you. You don't know who they are, or they might react badly. Again, you don't know them. You don't know what their beliefs are, or even if they want to hear the message. If it's just information like hearing the news, you may not want to tell other people. And it may not be that you have to tell someone. The universe will get that message to someone if it's meant to be given. Now, if you're not highly skilled with your intuition, you may be giving them the wrong information, or you might not be getting enough information to know the meaning of it and why. See, it's because intuition information can be very complex, and if you're not skilled with using your intuition and you think you know what it's telling you, but you could be wrong because you don't have the skills yet. I know when intuition's talking to me, so I know how to check it and check what it's saying for a bunch of reasons. First, I might get many pieces of intuition at once. That's because I've developed my skill. Other people might just get one piece of information. It might be a feeling. It might be a short little phrase. It might be a feeling coupled with a phrase, but nothing else. So when you have your intuition skill very well developed, this is one of the things that you do, is you actually develop enough of that skill so that you get a lot of different pieces of information intuitively. From that, you can get more information. Now, I have gotten a lot of experience with knowing the different ways intuition can come to me, and that allows me to check in and either collect more intuition information, or I can tell right away what kind of information it is. That is, whether it's real intuition or it's my thinking mind or my emotions. Other people who are less skilled might be confused and not really know. Or oftentimes what I've found with students is that they get an intuitive, what I call pop-up, and then their thinking mind takes over and they put a lot of reasons and rationale over it, or what we would say, jump to a conclusion. And that gets you into trouble because it's gone off in the wrong direction. Now, when you develop your intuition skill, I can get more meaning rather than just that feeling or that pop-up thought or phrase that seems like intuition, and I can check it. So there are a few things you need to know about when you get intuitive information, or you get intuition or you think you've gotten it. Is number one, understand that intuition is like the news. It's like you turned on your favorite news channel, or you're looking at, you know, news on your phone, and it's just information. Does it mean you need to act on it? Not necessarily. The second thing is that intuition gives you pieces. That's the nature of it. It comes in a little piece here, a little piece there. So you might not understand the entire context. And thirdly, you need a strong intuition skill to know if you really should tell someone else. Now, you may have had an intuition experience in the past, and it might have contradicted, or it may contradict different experiences that you have. So what does that mean? Maybe one time you think it warned you, and other times you thought it was fake. And this all can be because you're missing other intuition indicators and other intuition pieces of information to clearly understand its meaning. So that's why if you're like this, if this is what happens to you, then your skill needs to work on it. It's sort of undeveloped right now. And you can easily be fooled or misinterpret what you think is intuition. So this is where it's even more important to learn how to develop your skill and not feel that, I'm getting something for someone and I need to tell them. Now, not all intuition is meant to take action on, but what you can do is to take note of it. If you're highly skilled with your intuition, you can ask your intuition, what is the purpose of this information? What should I do with it? You might find that it is giving you a piece of information you can act on later. So I don't want you to feel burdened. Don't feel like you have to be compelled to do something. And this is one of the things that I find people come to me with. It's like, I don't know what to do. I feel like maybe I should tell somebody, or that I'm going to prevent something bad from happening. And I believe that all things happen for a reason, and that if the universe was meant to send a message to someone, you're not necessarily the messenger. I believe that, you know, there is this concept around intuition that everything that comes is a divine notion or a divine message or something. You know, it sort of harkens to more towards what we see again in the movies, I've gotten this information. I have to do something about it. You don't have to do something about it. Again, unless you're highly skilled and you can really understand what it's for. But even then, you run the risk of giving it to someone who may not be ready to receive it. And I believe that the information, if they need to have it, will be given to them when it is they need it. We're not always the messenger. Sometimes we may be able to give them a message in different ways, right? Maybe it's just that you have the knowing and you have the knowledge so that you can treat them differently, right? It might be that you know that this person's going through a tough time because they're getting divorced, and you just intuitively know that. It wasn't something that they told you. You just know. Well, maybe your role is to be kind to them or be considerate of that. So that's what it is. It's information. Remember, it's all information. And when you're better skilled with your intuition, you can get more actionable information from it. But until then, you can just ask and have the intention, ask the universe to give the message to whoever needs it, whichever way it needs to be gotten there, until you know whether it's something that you should act on or not, and be sure of it. I always like to ask the universe to do things for others' highest good and get it to them the best way for them. Isn't that freeing? You know, we are co-creators in the universe, and in that case, you can leave it up to your co-creator partner to get the right messages to where they belong. And, you know, our co-creator partner is all that is, right? So that's what I believe we should do when we get our intuitive pop-ups and we feel that, this is a message for someone else. Well, it might be, but I think it's safer to, until you get very skilled with your intuition, and even then you have to be cautious. That, you know, again, is it really something that I have to tell someone else? Again, it's just information. It's like the news. And it will get where it needs to go because I believe that's the way things work. Anyway, if you like this podcast, I would love it if you would give us a review. I do read them all. And if you could go pop over to iTunes and put the review there, that's really the only place that it can be done. I've got a couple out there, but I would just love to see what you think of us in terms of reviewing Between Heaven and Earth Radio. And if you want to get the link, you can go to betweenheavenandearthradio.com and the link to not only all our other episodes and how to listen to us in a better way, but you can also see where you can leave us a review. All right, that's it for now. Thanks for listening.